heaven.
They probably will.
But no one knows for sure.
That's for sure.
No one knows what happens after we die.
If we are good, we will be happy in heaven with God.
That's what many people believe.
If we are bad, will we be unhappy forever in hell?
I don't want to go to hell.
Let's go to church with your parents on Sunday.
My husband died.
I'm sorry for you.
Thank you.
When did he die?
A couple of months ago.
You still miss him?
Yes, but I talk to him almost every day.
When you go to church?
No, when I call him on his cell phone.
What do you mean?
I buried him with his cell phone.
What will you do when the battery dies? Today is Friday the 13th.
That's a bad day.
It's supposed to be unlucky.
You're supposed to stay home all day.
That's what I do.
My friend stayed in a hotel on Friday the 13th.
That was a mistake.
He stayed on the 13th floor.
What happened?
Someone stole his laptop.
He was asking for it.
He learned his lesson. He's home today. Do you love me? Do you really love me?
Of course.
Prove it.
How can I prove it?
Take me to dinner.
That's it? That's all I have to do?
Take me to a nice restaurant, not to McDonald's.
But a nice restaurant costs money.
Yes, and you have to make a reservation.
That's such a hassle.
I knew you didn't love me.
Okay. I'll make a reservation right now.
My parents are divorced.
So are mine.
Why did your parents get divorced?
My father found a new girlfriend.
That's too bad.
My mother was hurt and angry.
She had good reason. What did she do?
She told him to drop his girlfriend.
What did your father do?
He moved out of our house.
I guess he really liked his new girlfriend.
Yes, but she left him a year later.
My grandma's apartment smells funny.
So does mine.
I think it's old people smell.
Really?
Yes. I think when you get old, you begin to smell.
Like fruit that is too ripe?
Yes, just like fruit that is too ripe.
But the smell is different.
Yes, old people don't smell like fruit.
No, they smell like a thrift shop.
Yes, a thrift shop has that same smell.
Yes, and an old smell. The price of stamps goes up and up.
I think stamps used to cost a penny.
That was a long time ago.
It was before I was born.
Now, a stamp is 42 cents.
But in May, it will be 44 cents.
Have you ever lost a letter in the mail?
No, I haven't.
Neither have I.
So, they do a good job for the money.
Yes, they do.
Maybe we shouldn't complain.
A button came off my shirt.
What are you going to do?
First, I have to find the button.
Where did you lose it?
I have no idea.
A button is hard to find. Did you look in your pant cuffs?
That's a good idea.
I found a button in my pant cuffs one time.
Let me look. No, it's not there.
Many shirts come with an extra button.
You're right. This one does have an extra button.
Now, all you have to do is sew it on.
I have to go to the bathroom.
You drink too much coffee.
But I love coffee.
Well, it's your life.
You eat too much chocolate.
I don't think so.
Have you looked in the mirror?
Do you think I'm getting fat?
I didn't say that.
What did you say?
I said I have to go to the bathroom.
That's what I thought you said. Did you do the laundry?
Yes, I did.
What did you wash?
I washed the sheets and towels.
What about the pillowcases?
Yes, I took them off the pillows and washed them.
Did you dry everything in the dryer?
Yes, I dried everything in the dryer.
Then what did you do?
I folded all the towels.
Did you put the sheets on the bed?
Yes, I put the pillowcases on the pillows. Do you listen to the radio?
I listen day and night.
What do you listen to?
Mostly talk radio.
What's that?
People talk about current events.
What do they say?
They say they want change.
What kind of change?
They want tax cuts.
Why do they want tax cuts?
Because tax cuts will save them money.
Mom, I'm hungry.
Look in the fridge.
I'm looking. There's nothing to eat.
Are you sure?
It's almost empty.
I went to the market yesterday.
I don't see anything.
I bought lots of oranges and apples.
I don't want fruit. I want something tasty.
Eat the fruit. It's good for you.
Next time you go to the market, let me go with you.
No, thank you. All you want to eat are hot dogs and candy bars. What is there to eat?
I don't know. Look in the fridge.
I think I'll make a sandwich.
What kind?
A ham sandwich.
The bread is in the cabinet.
Where's the mustard?
It's in the fridge, I think.
Oh, yes, here it is. Do you want a sandwich?
Yes, that sounds nice.
How about some potato chips?
Yes, and a pickle if we have any.
It's time for your bath, young lady.
But Mom, I'm not dirty.
You need a bath every day.
Why?
Because you don't want to smell bad.
I don't smell bad.
That's what you think.
If I smelled bad, I could smell me.
I could smell you.
I can smell you too.
That's my perfume.
When can I wear perfume?
Something's wrong with my computer.
Exactly what?
All I get is a black screen.
What's the matter?
I think I know because this happened before.
What happened before?
My hard drive crashed.
Oh no, that's bad news.
It sure is, but I'm going to call HP first, just to make sure.
Will you lose all your files?
No, I always back up my files.
You're smart. I called HP about my computer.
What did they say?
They said I need a new hard drive.
That's too bad. How much is a new one?
It's not too much, only about $85.
Plus installation?
No, my hard drive is easy to remove and replace.
Really?
Yes, it's just a couple of screws.
That's nice.
It's a lot better than paying someone $60.
If my hard drive crashes, I'll just call you. What's your email address?
It's BlueDog123.
BlueDog123? Are you sure that's all?
Yes.
No, that's incomplete.
What do you mean?
What's your mailing address?
456 Cherry Drive, Pasadena, California, 91170.
That's correct.
So, what's the problem?
Blue Dog 123 is just the street. You have to give me the city, state, and zip code.
Oh, I get it. My email address is bluedog123@yahoo.com. I'm going to take a nap.
You should unplug the phone.
That's a good idea.
Do you want me to wake you in an hour?
No, thanks. Just let me sleep until I wake up.
I'll start dinner at 6 o'clock.
Okay. I think I'll be awake by then.
If not, your nose will wake you up.
You mean I will smell the food cooking?
You might even dream about dinner.
I don't think I'm going to dream about anything. I'm really tired.
Have a nice nap. That was a nice funeral.
Yes, Dad, it was.
The son gave a nice speech about his father.
It was long, too.
I think it was about 45 minutes long.
But it went by fast. It was interesting.
I liked it.
I'll give you a speech like that, too.
Do you think anyone will come to my funeral?
Of course.
I think only the family will be there.
You have lots of friends. They will be there, too. Yikes! What's that noise?
I had to blow my nose.
Did you have to blow right next to the phone?
Did you hear that?
Of course I heard that. I thought a plane had crashed into your house.
It wasn't that loud.
I will blow my nose sometime for you, and you'll see.
Okay, I'll take your word for it.
I thought you had an elephant in your house.
You're funny.
What did you say? I think I've gone deaf.
I'm going into the bathroom to blow my nose. I'll be right back. I have lots of friends.
Really? How many do you have?
I don't know, maybe 100?
That is a lot of friends. Do you have a best friend?
Of course, I have lots of best friends.
How many best friends do you have?
I think about 25.
I have only one best friend.
I feel sorry for you.
I have only a few friends.
You must be lonely. I will share my friends with you.
That's very nice of you. Now, don't you ever cheat on me.
Why would I do that?
Because men like to cheat.
Some men do, but not me.
I'm watching you.
I'm an open book. Watch me all you want.
If I catch you, you'll be sorry.
You won't catch me because I love you. I'm not a cheater.
I will poke your eyes out.
I don't want any other woman.
I will chop your toes off one by one.
Honey, please. You're the only woman for me forever. I swear it. I hate to go outside.
Me too.
Why do you hate to go outside?
I meet too many jerks.
I agree.
This city is full of jerks.
Rude people are everywhere.
But what can you do?
You could yell at them.
And they will yell back at you.
Yelling doesn't do any good.
No, the best thing to do is just stay home.
Will you look at this form?
Are you having problems with it?
I don't understand some things.
Let me help you.
What does M.I. mean?
M.I. stands for middle initial.
What does M.M./D.D./Y.Y. mean?
That means month, day, year. Use numbers.
I don't understand.
For example, if your birth date is January 12th, 1987, write 01/12/87.
Oh, that's simple enough.
Always print clearly and fill in the bubbles completely.